Welcome to another show series by Women Lead TV, brought to you by Connected Women of Influence. I'm Michelle Bergquist, your host of Bad Ass Business Women. It's fun to say. Can you say that?
I love it. Bad Ass Business Women.
Well, we want to know that you're badass
and you're
a business
woman. It just rolls off the tongue, yes.
To our viewing audience, this is Marcy Browe, and she is a branding photographer, all around smarty pants on visual. And just, I'm getting to know her, and delightful that you are badass. So I know you're quick on your feet. What makes you a badass businesswoman? I'm going to ask that right out the gate.
Sure. I consider myself a badass businesswoman because I support other women and I build them up. And I really think that is the first step to being badass because we're a tribe of females. And if
how do you do this? You go like this?
Yeah, the rock star, you know.
Okay, you have to hold this way?
Yeah, hold it this way.
I'm in my mid-50s, sister.
Oh,
I don't know this stuff. So, okay, we're good. Okay.
Yeah, it's a rock salute, yeah.
Okay. I need a leather jacket, I'm thinking. Now let's get serious, Marcy. So you know, you and I spent some wonderful time together just about a week ago, and I was so impressed with your background and your purpose and your passion in what you do with photography. But do you mind for our viewing audience and listeners, like how did you get into photography? Because you've got a great story.
Sure. So I was born into the photography business because my grandfather was a portrait photographer, and he had a business. He first started his studio in Pittsburgh, and then he moved to Long Island, where he finished out his career. So I inherited his cameras, and by the time I inherited them, they were probably 1970s style cameras.
But so this was in the time, just so we have context, with the dark room.
Oh, with the dark room,
and the little zippy things with the photos.
Yes. Yeah, it was incredibly cool because now that I'm using all digital editing, and it really is like the dark room, but it's all done digitally. So it's super cool because it's just way more advanced because you can do a lot with photos now that you couldn't back in the day.
Because the manipulation part, like you put things, put people in front of things where they never could before.
Yeah.
Like, is any photo actually really great? Like, let's go with something for a moment. So let's look behind us.
Yes.
And of course we're in a downtown high rise in downtown New York City, but where are we really?
Well, we're in Carlsbad, Beachside, California. So we are not in a high rise and we're basically looking at the ocean instead of
a
skyline.
A train. We have a train goes by every once in a while, which is, you know, the power of like visual effects.
It is true.
And I know there's so much more to that, but you know, for you in your photography business, like what do you try to do with some of your clientele? Because I know it's not just portrait. You do such a variety of things. But I loved your answer when we kind of sat down that one day with lunch and a lot of wine. But
yes, that's how we roll though. So so I was born into the photography business, if you will, but I never thought I was going to be a photographer. It was just a hobby just a hobby. And I really found early that I loved photographing people. So if you were a friend of mine throughout my learning photography, there is photos of you. I have. So
there's a threat there that you could do. Like, I'm sure.
There could be. I can dig through the archives.
I got a lot of stuff about you. I love that.
But I went to school and I got a degree in advertising because I was super inspired by the advertising world. And then I worked for 15 years. I had a degree in advertising, but I worked in marketing, advertising, and then I sold advertising. So that was my corporate gig. So now what I do is I take all of that learning and sensibility and I apply it to my photography clients, because what I do is I do photography with your marketing in mind, because there's a lot of people that can take beautiful photos, but really these photos need to speak to your ideal audience. So you don't need just like a glamour shot, you need a really strong image.
I hate that look.
I know. Yes, the glamour shots from the
the 80s or something.
They're from the 80s. Remember, they were in the mall and you would wear
totally
like a feather boa and then they would gloss
Olin
it.
Mills.
Totally. Well, the Olin Mills was like the square traditional studio, but the glamour shots were the glamour photos.
So question for you, because this is what I loved when you said you did branding and photography, because we both have a very good common friend and buddy, Sarah Clark Williams. Beautiful photos. I know she works with you. I'm really curious, how do you pull the best out of somebody with their brand? Maybe because some people, we don't know how, like when somebody says stick my rear end out.
Oh yeah.
And then I'm like, I can't believe how fabulous that looked on the photography, but I'm so uncomfortable.
I'll tell you why that works in a second. So stay tuned. Stay tuned for opposing. But with the brand, so it just starts with a conversation. And I have a brand planning guide, and anyone can download it. It's on my website.
Go with that. So what's your website?
My website is marcybrow.com, and I'm sure there'll be a link under
Let's
this video.
Let's spell it Marcy, M-A-R-C-Y.
B-R-O-W-E. So if you go to marcybrow.com.
Yep. There's different ones. You got to say it now.
I know. It's a .com. Yeah. And so if you go to my website, you can download this brand planning guide.
I love this.
What I take my clients through. And it's pretty simple, but after you go through this brand planning guide, you'll have a little bit more confidence. Yeah, take notes. I can send it to you. But, but you'll have more confidence with what your brand is. So I ask you a series of questions, and they could be used as journal prompts, or we can use them in our pre-planning session. And the questions are, how do you want your clients to feel after you work with them? What kind of language do you want people to say when they talk about you? And then I give them words. Like, if you don't know what language you want, I have a whole set of prompts. Like, circle the words that describe you, and then you can kind of use that to really hone in on what your brand is. And that informs your photos.
I love that.
And then with Sarah, she's really spunky, but she's also very smart and bright. So we had to balance her spunk. She's got a high
peppy.
Spunk factor.
Yeah,
yes.
I like that word, high spunk. That's her.
But she also is like very serious and good at what she does as a business coach. So we had to mix both of those together. And then she has these brand colors she already uses. So we used those in her photos. Mm-hmm. And that's just one example. And then other people are more like heart-centered and quiet. And, you know, so that needs to come through in their photos too. You can't do the same photos for everybody.
Do you do a lot of front end work with your clients before you ever? I mean, I don't.
Yes.
I don't know photographers that do that or. Do, yeah. I mean, I've just never heard of that.
I do. So today I photographed a woman and she's running for city council in Carlsbad where we're sitting. And so when I spoke with her, I noticed her website had a lot of like blue and red, which a lot of people
really,
do.
Really, red, white, and blue for a politician?
Yeah, I know.
What a shock.
So exactly. So I was like, don't wear any red or blue, and just because. I feel like she had a really great opportunity to stand out from that kind of generic political. So she went with a lot of like earthy colors, and then we went through a Pinterest board together. I sent it to her, and she sent me photos back, and she showed me what she liked. And she was the kind of person that was like very much, I want this. She took control of the situation, but not
everyone's
like.
Is that a good
thing?
I mean,
in her case,
okay,
yes.
Yeah.
Because it was great. She walked into my studio, and I knew exactly how I was going to photograph her. But some people don't know, and that just comes through with the pre-planning.
You know, first of all, you're wonderfully verbal. It's like, I mean, I see photography as, you know, so many photographers I've known, it's like they like to be behind the scenes, right? And, you know, getting the best out of people is great. But as a business, tell me a little bit about how, in talking to you, like you really learned the business side of photography. And tell me what kind of your journey was for that. Because I think that's a great marriage, and more creatives need to kind of find that. And there's a lot of people that have side hustles and their hobby, but how do they turn it into a business?
That is a great question, because when I left the corporate world and I decided to start my business, I had a little mantra that I would say in my head.
I don't know this.
Okay,
I can't wait to hear it.
One of my idols is Annie Leibovitz. She's a photographer. She does a lot of Vanity Fair covers, and she does like very beautiful iconic photos of people. And so I always said to myself, I might not ever rise to the level of her talent, but I'm going to market myself better than anybody I know, because that was my skill.
And you were in advertising. So
I was in advertising, and I was very used to marketing and the corporate side. So I decided that I was going to learn the skills that I didn't have already with it just being a hobby. So for me, I got a photo mentor. I paid for a lot of online education. I attended a lot of workshops.
Wow.
And then with the business side, same thing. I hired a business coach. I hired a sales coach. And so I really just saw where I had gaps in my knowledge and skill set. And I just worked to get better at that. And I hired people.
Well, and I love that. I mean, for you, it's like, where some of these elements, like where, like on the sales coach side, because, you know, it's hard for any of us to sell, not just women, not just small business owners, but, you know, persuading and getting people to buy from you. What have been some of the best takeaways that you've found that have really worked for you, if you don't mind sharing.
Absolutely. So what was a really good switch for me after working with a sales coach, and her name is Julia Andrews.
Give credit where credit is due.
I know.
I mean, just like how you just put it right out there. Yeah. You want to spell her name and give her website?
Her name is Julia Andrews. It's pretty easy
great.
To spell.
Awesome.
But she worked a lot with me with developing a couple of things. And one was a presentation I could give on stage, which then led to soft selling myself, if you will. Mm-hmm. And so that was a new concept for me, and it was called Speak to Sell. And we actually have a member of our group, Connected Women of Influence, that does a similar process. This is Rebecca Massoud, so I want to give a shout out to the community.
Sparkle, shine,
yes,
sell.
Speak, shine, sell is what
it.
Her program.
I knew it was like that.
And then she also helped me with the sales process of recognizing just how to structure a sales conversation, and then how to lead someone from an inquiry to a sales. And then she also helped me with my contact form on my website so people could funnel into a sales process. So those are
that's
some
awesome.
Specific ways that she helped me.
Well, that's the most awesome thing to hear about another CWI member.
I know.
I'm like,
yeah.
I get excited over that. So yay.
Yes.
Yay, yay. You know, for you, in the long time you've been in business, what are some of the things that really, and if you're willing to share, that have been kind of a struggle?
Yes.
And that you wish you could have done it differently if you had to go back? Because there's like a zillion things I would do differently if
oh
I could rewind
gosh.
Time.
I know. I feel like I could throw out
that
20,
should be
20
a book
things.
Is
that
what
should
not
be.
To do,
I know.
Right? Yeah.
I know. And when, so immediately what comes to mind is I was trying to do everything myself. Yeah. And I was really
common problem.
Resistant to hiring an assistant. And I just barely hired an assistant, and I've already seen so much more of me just elevating what I'm focusing on as opposed
Great.
To focusing on the day-to-day stuff.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I wish I would have the confidence to do that earlier. So that's one thing that I really wish I could have gone
back.
And
you know, everybody says that you need to start with, I mean, like some people call them the mini-me, right? And there's
yeah.
no one that will work as hard as you as
right.
an owner. So we all,
yeah.
sorry folks, you cannot hire that miracle employee. But, you know, that said, it's like for you, it's like, how did you get them on board? Because I've heard owners that will say, I brought on my admin or my great assistant.
Yes.
But then you've got to be prepared for them
yes.
and help them be successful. What did you,
yes.
you know, what did you learn, and how are you making that work?
Well, that is a good point, because you don't just have an assistant on board and then there's a lot
like,
of
here
onboarding.
You go.
Yes.
Yeah, it doesn't work that way.
So what I did was the processes that I wanted her to take over, I filmed myself. I did a training and I just did a film, and I just used Zoom. So that was the tool that was available to me and free, and I just filmed it. So
oh,
I
like instruction with
exactly.
Zoom.
Exactly.
Okay.
So
yeah,
and then I can actually go through, because I wanted her to blog and do my newsletter. So
okay.
I would just go through the programs that I wanted her to use, and I would film it. So that way, and then if I don't use this assistant in the future, I already
You're
have
ready.
It. Yeah, I already have it. I already have the documentation. So that was a huge process, just documenting. And then we had to just have a lot of check-ins throughout the process to
mm-hmm.
say, okay, is there anything you can tweak or I can tweak? And so it's an evolving process.
Super awesome. And you know, I think so many people, when they start a business, Marcy, me included, I left corporate America and I'm thinking, I don't want to do anything of how corporate America worked,
yes.
right? I don't want procedures, I don't want policies, I don't want to have standard protocol and all
mm-hmm.
of that. But share, you know, at least for other owners that might be thinking about starting a business, did that, was that how you felt? And did you
yes.
finally embrace protocol and procedures?
Yes.
And because I love that, but share your story on that one. That's a big one.
It is a big yeah. one. And what, I mean, there's just so much extra fluff in corporate, and really,
yeah,
you know, you can really cut the fat in a corporate organization. And I saw a lot of waste, and I saw a lot of not environmentally wise decisions in corporate, because I would do
right.
a lot of trade shows. And at the end of the trade show, you basically just scoop things up and throw them out, essentially. And that would
That's
infuriate me. Yeah. Or I would be flying to cities that I'm like, how about a phone call? You know, I just would
yeah.
see this waste in corporate. So for me, it wasn't so much as, you know, replicating or eliminating procedures I didn't like. For me, I had an opportunity. How do I want to ethically set up my business so I am a certified green business and I give a portion of my profit back to a few green organizations? So
oh,
for me,
awesome.
I just really thought, what? Why am I doing this, and what do I really
mm-hmm.
care about? What am I
mm-hmm.
passionate about, and how can I walk the talk?
And you do. I'm like, seriously, and I can't even imagine how valuable your advertising experience is, because again, with creatives, it's like we make, we don't. And I put myself into that because I used to do corporate gifts,
mm-hmm.
but you know, you make, you don't think of it as a business.
And right.
You know, for you in advertising, can you share a couple of marketing nuggets?
Yes.
Because today, photos and yes. video are so important to business. What would be some slices of advice you would give people about the marketing side of their business?
So in a marketing...
In our limited time.
And then I do want to end with the tip of the posing tip.
What
I had a boss that would say to me anytime I wrote anything that was marketing related, whether it was a newsletter or anything that an external audience would write, he said, take out the word I or me and replace it with you, because you were talking to someone, you're not talking about yourself.
Oh, great tip.
And it was just so subtle, but anytime you find yourself talking about yourself, you're probably doing it wrong.
Right, because nobody cares, mm-hmm. right? They're looking at how will I fit
exactly.
you.
Or,
that's great advice.
Yes.
So swap out the I with you.
Yeah.
It's so funny because we do the suit talks and we tell them, don't say you, say I.
Oh, well, but that's different because you're on stage and you're
yeah.
bringing an audience in.
Right.
Yeah, you're not selling in that scenario.
Exactly. I'm trying to be funny and I'm so not right now. So in our last moment, what's the last thing you want to share with our viewing audience
them? You did mention how when you were getting your photos done, they said stick your butt out. And I laughed because...
I said fanny. I think, no, I'm just teasing. I didn't. Stick your butt out.
Tushy.
Yeah.
And I have to talk about body parts. So I'm always like, tush. Like, I don't know what to call the butt. So the reason is because... And this is something anyone watching can walk away with. If you want to make something smaller on camera, you move it further away. So if you're feeling bottom heavy, you just lean towards the camera, because the camera exaggerates things. So whatever's closest to the camera looks bigger. So you got to just stick your booty back. And then that will really help me.
So if I lean back, that's better if I want to seem smaller?
Oh, sorry. No, you. If you're sitting, you keep your tush back and then you lean your torso forward.
So I'm going to look smaller.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm smaller.
Yes.
what else you got? Let's go with one more.
Okay, so one more is if you want to... Okay,
this is really uncomfortable, by the way.
It doesn't feel good. It's exactly. I know. And so... If you're also with posing, a lot of times I just say, look right at the camera, look like you're looking at someone you really like, and that will create an authentic expression.
I'm looking at the camera.
Yeah, so you just look at the camera like it's someone you like, or you know, you want to get to know better. Yeah.
I love this. I'm going to have you back for more. I mean, this is great advice. And, you know, one other question for you. Tell our audience how you feel more women can be badass at what they do in business.
Oh, my gosh. I think we just need to have more confidence, because I feel a lot of women diminish, or they put other things first. But I feel like we just need to have more confidence. And confidence really is that secret ingredient that really paves the path to just getting so much more in life.
What's your thought on fake confidence? Like, just fake it till you make it. Think that can work?
Maybe. I feel like the confidence comes from really within. So if you don't really feel good in your skin or confident, then you might not actually be exuding like realness.
Okay, I like that. So. But it's like the confidence, man, that's a big one, isn't it, for so many of us?
It is, and it's so easy just to say, just be confident. But, you know, there's a lot of self-development that goes into that. So it's not an easy thing. It's easy to say, but not really easy to do.
And that's awesome. We're at a wrap. So thank you for being our badass businesswoman.
Thank
you.
Wait,
I'm going to lean in, and I'm going to look lovingly at the camera and say, thank you for being on Women Lead TV. That's our show segment for today. We'll be back again with another Women Lead TV show, and that is a wrap. We'll be right back.